What's going on, everyone? Welcome, Rabid here, and today we're going to be taking a look at some mining profitability, starting off with GPUs for October of 2023. So here we are coming in. It looks like we are seeing some profitability, a fair bit better than last month. I believe we had profit on a 4090, which isn't at the top of the list anymore because NVIDIA isn't quite as good at mining Dynex as AMD. And a recent miner just released for SRB that did improve AMD as well as NVIDIA hash rate, but it definitely looks like AMD took off a little bit. So here we can see on the 6800 XT, we're about 18 cents, 11 cents per kilowatt hour of some profit here. Radeon 7s are sitting at 16 cents. We got the 6800 at 14, 6900s, 13 cents. Let's scroll on down to see what we got for some NVIDIA GPUs. We got the 4090 at 10 cents, 4070 Ti at 8 cents. And then you can just see everything from that point slips down to probably not worth turning anything on. Again, you know, obviously if you're mining long term, getting the yields now is probably worth it, especially if something like Dynex goes 10 to 100x. You know, that would be awesome in the bull run, but we don't know how well these coins will prevail yet. So here we are, GPUs are looking better than last month, but still not 100% the best way to go about mining. All right, so here we are at my CPU mining calculator at rabidmining.com. Link in the description. Check it out if you are a CPU miner. And I also got links on my website here to builds out and builds of CPUs and so on and parts and all that other good stuff. Anyway, we're at a 3900X here, 11 cents per kilowatt hour again. I'm just going to recalculate everything. And we can see Dagger is about 32 cents after power, 61 cents if you have free power. Yada coin is looking like about 20 cents. Zeph is down to about 18 cents. So that's about on par with the best GPU right now. So the third place coin here is about the same as the best GPU. That's currently the most profitable. We got Bittorium coming in at 13 cents. We got Avian at 10 cents. Raptorium's even profitable at 5 cents. Monero is still profitable. It's only 2 cents. So, but you know, for a long time, it hasn't been profitable at all. So we do have some profitability across there. We're going to move up to, let's say, a 5950X here. We're going to calculate that out. And it's looking like we got Dagger at 28, Avian at 20, Yadacoin at 14, Zeph at 12, Panda Knights at 3 cents, Bittorium at 2 cents. Now we're going to jump into, let's go for the 7950X. Calculate that out, everything again, 11 cents per kilowatt hour. So 7950X looks like about 52 cents after power, 35 on Yadacoin, 33 cents on Zeph. Dero is about 28 cents, Bittorium 25, and Avian 21. So it's quite a bit more coins, a little more profitable. 7950Xs are nice and efficient CPUs. Now we got the Epic. Let's load that bad boy up. Calculations. And the Epic is coming in at $1.44 after power, 97 cents, 91 on Zeph, 64 cents on Dero here. We got Bittorium 64, Avian 55 cents, Raptorium 36 cents. Now let's take a peek at the dual Epic. Load the big guy up right here. This thing is an absolute beast. And we have $2.71 after power. Yadacoin is $1.76. Zeph is $1.66. Bittorium is 98 cents. We got Raptorium at 46 and Monero at 40 cents. Now, here's the one big bad boy, Bitmain X5, the big, huge CPU miner, which can only mine XMR. If it could mine other coins, this thing would be awesome. Look at Dagger. If it could nail out some Dagger here, that's $6.75 after power. Yadacoin is $4.64. Zeph is $4.40. But it can only mine Monero XMR, which is $1.59. Sad times for the X5. All right, so now let's take a look at some ASIC profitability. And we got Bitmain's KS3 8.3 terahash model is $139 after power. So that's pretty insane here, 11 cents per kilowatt hour. Again, the Bitmain Antminer S21, this is an actual Bitcoin miner that uses over 5,000 watts, but it is making over $7.15. Insane. The Jazzminer X16P, which is only available in like massive bulk orders. So obviously a home miner is not getting their hands on this. And it's, you know, it's hard to source out at this point. Regardless, that thing is making almost $5 at $4.95. We got the K7 at $4.55. S21 is coming in at $3.47. The big D9 is $2.95. Here it has Bitmain's X5 at $2.89. That seems too high for me. We just looked at it on my calculator, and no thanks. I do not want to be no domain stuff. The Bitmain AppMiner L7 ScriptMiner 9.5 GHz version script is down to only $2.80. This used to be upwards of $11. Things are changing, guys. Crazy how these bear markets play out. And regardless, we'll move down to maybe the X16Q here is $1.79. Let's take a look at what Mine the ASIC does have to tell us here. And we can see the KS3 9.4 terahash version is about $169. You got the Bitmain KS3 at 8.3 terahash. $149. We got the KS3 from Ice River at $143. KS3M, which is pretty much an overclocked KS3L, is $104. And we got the KS2 is about $34 a day. KS1, $17.39. Where's the KS0? Way down here in 23rd place, $1.73. So ASICs, there's some ASICs that are still top of the charts. Obviously, Kaspa is still cleaning house with the profitability, but we are seeing an everlasting increase in hash rate like crazy, and we have block reward reductions happening every single month. The next one is actually set to happen in 4 days at the time of recording, so we're going to see those numbers drop fairly soon, unless, of course, that price does go up. Are you looking for ASIC miners, just not sure who to trust? Head on over to Crypto Miner Bros. They do have the latest models of all the popular brands from Bitmain, Ice River, Goldshell, Jazzminer, iPollo, MicroBT, IBLink, Canna and Avalon, and in Silicon. We got the S21 is already on order. I believe shipping begins in May. This thing is 200 terahash at 3,000 watts. On top of the X5 XMR miner, we got some hydro-cooled Bitcoin miners, and of course the S19K. Be sure to use my link in the description, and code RABID will grant you $50 off per item that you purchase at any given time, as well as shipping fees are calculated in the price already, and they drop the value so that import fees are next to nothing. All right, so now we're going to take a look at FPGAs, more particular the E300. I just updated these coins to the current network difficulties and hash rates. Actually, Kaspa I'm going to remove because that, you know, doesn't count anymore. Kaspa is gone. So here we have Kyla Coin, Ironfish, and Radiant. Now, Ironfish, I have the numbers in for the C1100, which I just tested the other day. So if you're looking for hash rates and how to set that up in HiveOS, be sure to check out that video for the C1100. But that was doing about 49 gigahash on Ironfish. So before power, that's about 49 cents. It does use 81 watts, and it was about 21 watts or 21 cents here worth of power at 11 cents per kilowatt hour. So the profitability is about 28 cents. Now, the E300, the VU35P version, is about 152 gigahash. I'm just going to scroll up to confirm that right quick here. Ironfish, yes, 152.9. We're going to rock 152. So that is actually, it looks like $1.53. I was like, what am I talking about? That's crazy. Actually, I got to put the power in here. I'm totally butchering this. I apologize, guys, but we got to get these numbers accurate. So that is for 239 watts. So I got to adjust this to 239. I thought it was looking a little too profitable there. 239 watts, there we go. So on the E300, the Ironfish here is making $1.53 before power. It uses 239 watts. Power cost is 63 cents. So we are actually making 90 cents after power. So Ironfish is still in green for the E300s, where Radiant is coming in second, it's looking like here. $1.98 before power, 486 watts, $1.28 worth of power cost at 11 cents per kilowatt hour, 70 cent profit. And Kyla Coin is not looking too hot. The price has come down. It's only $108 right now. That network hash rate is also up somehow for that reason, but we are making 85 cents if you had free power. It does use 423 watts, $1.11 worth of power cost at 11 cents per kilowatt hour, and we are negative 25 cents mining Kyla Coin now on these E300s. So right now it does look like Ironfish is still the most profitable coin to be mining on the E300s, and it also sounds like the vote went through and they're updating their hash rate algorithm. So a new algorithm is coming to fork away from FPGAs and everything on Ironfish. I believe it's called Fish Hash. That is probably the weirdest name I've ever heard of. Like, let's check out some Fish hash rates. Like, that doesn't even sound right. Regardless, they call the Fish Hash for some weird reason. I don't go behind the planning here. Maybe you guys like that. I have no idea. But I think they need a different name for that algorithm before they actually totally release it. You know, Son of a Tech actually came out with Aqua Hash, which sounds a lot better than something like fish hash. But regardless, enough about fish hash chat here. These are the current profitability numbers. FPGAs and stuff, Ironfish is currently the most profitable to mine. Until they do that algo swap, then it's looking like something like Radiant for now. So there we go, guys. This is October of 2023 mining profitabilities. Thank you for checking this out. I will see you on the next one. Rabid out.